McMahon? It is I, Tony Khan.
I'm sorry. Who are you?
What? You really don't know who I am? Tony Khan.
Oh, yeah. I know who you are. You're related to Nick Khan, are you?
No, I'm not related to Nick Khan, the president of your company.
Oh, come on.
Stop joking. You know who I am.
I'm just kidding. I know who you are. Tony Khan. The president of that company. What is it called again?
All Elite Wrestling?
Yeah. All Elite Wrestling. So what do you want? How did you get my number anyway? Nobody supposed to have my number. Not even my kids.
Well, Mr. McMahon, I was calling you to let you know that I am taking over your business.
What? What the hell are you talking about?
I'm telling you that I'm taking over the wrestling business. And sooner or later, the WWE will be gone. And all there will be left is All Elite Wrestling.
You've seriously got to be joking with me.
No, I'm not.
How are you exactly going to take over my business? A business that my family, from the startup, have built?
Well, I'm sure you've heard that in September, All Elite Wrestling will be taking over New York City.
Okay. Why are you telling me this?
I'm telling you this because, well, you practically are the home of your WWE. It's been famously known in New York City. I mean, you guys had WWF New York for what, how many years? I don't know. I mean, you practically own New York City. But since we are going to be coming in town, New York is going to be wanting us and not you.
That's funny. Can I ask where you're going to be performing? What stadium? What arena are you going to be performing at?
Well, we are going to be at the Arthur Ashe Stadium.
Isn't that a tennis arena?
Yeah. So what?
How come you couldn't get Madison Square Garden?
Well,
what about the Barclays Center?
Well, you know, it's just that...
Or, what about MetLife Stadium?
Well, you just let me talk...
I'll tell you why you couldn't get those arenas. Because our names are practically all over those arenas and stadiums. And they wouldn't let you dare step inside those arenas.
You know what, sir? It doesn't even matter anyways, because we're the better company anyway.
Ah, just stop it right there. Just stop. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, bigger and better than the WWE.
That's where you're wrong, Mr. McMahon. Because you see, over here at All Elite Wrestling, we treat our superstars with respect. We allow them to be themselves. We allow them to showcase their skills and produce them on every single show that we have. Unlike you, who doesn't even care about your talent.
You know, it's funny that you mention talent, considering that half of your roster used to work for me. See how Lota, Christian, Matt Hardy, Big Show, Dean Ambrose, Andrade, Rusev. Say hello to every single one of them over there. Because without me, they wouldn't be as relevant as they are in your company.
First of all, we don't call them by those stupid names that you've given them that they had to deal with for over 5 years. Just face it, Vince. You're done for. I'm the one that's going to be taking over this wrestling world. Sooner or later, people are going to realize that WWE is nothing but hype. You can't deliver on what you say. You tell your fans that you're gonna be, that they're gonna be the authority, that they are in charge. But since then, you haven't done anything to please your fans. Because all they do is simply complain. But with us, we care about our talent. We care about our fans. We care about what they think. Unlike you, who only cares about the money.
You think you're just so damn perfect? Well, it's time to open your eyes, because you're not. Your show constantly have botches every week. And at least one person on your roster gets injured. Unlike the WWE, we practice our wrestling. We make sure all of our stuff is safe. Unlike you.
And you actually think that's my fault?
Yes. When someone is injured during a match or concussed, whatever the case may be, you have to stop the match. It doesn't matter that you had all this stuff planned. You end the match right then and there.
Okay, whatever. But here's the thing. Does your world champion have 4 titles across 3 promotional brands? Does he? Or do they? I don't think so, pal.
And no, you're not talking about that Kenny Omega. Or what does Jim Cornette call them? McFingerbang. Whatever you want to call that idiotic champion you have. Like, who seriously takes someone like him serious? And if you want to talk about champion, we have 2 of the most dominant world champions across both Raw and SmackDown. We have the almighty Bobby Lashley. And then we have the head of the table, Roman Reigns, the best wrestler in the entire WWE and in all of professional wrestling.
Both guys are overrated, in my opinion, if you say so.
Overrated? Overrated? That word is associated with the Young Bucks and Kenny Omega. 2 teams who think they're the best in the world. Get out of here.
You know what? I don't need to hear this. Just understand this, Mr. McMahon. All Elite Wrestling is taking over the wrestling world. Pop culture, everybody, they're going to be talking about us. No one cares about the WWE anymore. You guys suck. All of your shows suck. And that champion of yours, Roman Reigns, he's the only thing that's making your show much relevant. Everything else is complete trash. That's why we're the reason why NXT had to move to Tuesdays, because they couldn't stand to handle and deal with us. Because we are the superior brand. We own Wednesday nights. We're the better brand. And there ain't nothing that you will ever do about it, sir.
No. Understand this, Mr. Khan. I don't give a damn who you have on your roster or what you do. The WWE has been around for over 60 years. We are a part of pop culture. We have made some of the biggest stars in Hollywood. Look at The Rock, John Cena, Batista. They all came from us. You really think somebody on your brand could be a bigger star than those 3 men that I just named? I don't think so. You're gonna have all the fancy stuff. You're gonna have anybody on my roster. But it doesn't matter because they're not WWE.